Yeah, I'm a clock tower. Oh, that's just gonna be tight. Okay, text me the address. 8 o'clock. Okay. Okay. All right. Steph left her phone at. So I gotta go get it before 8 o'clock.
What?
I gotta go get Steph's phone before 8 o'clock at a place. She left her phone at some swim lessons place. Let's get back to what we were doing. Chuck. All right, we out here. I'm out here with Mr. Cuck. We're gonna train some back today. So we just had our monthly managers meeting for the nutrition corners. Bobby's got this mic on me today, so I don't have to shout in the gym, which is good. So anyways, we're training back. So last video I think I spoke through was shoulders and arms. And during, when I was doing shoulders and arms, I was training back with chest. I was doing chest and back, shoulders and arms, and legs. Or actually chest and back, legs, shoulders and arms, day off for Pete. Right now, I'm back on a bro split. I've been traveling a ton the past, I don't know, 7 weeks. And so during that time period, I was on that split I just mentioned. But since I'm back at home, I just really wanted to take my time in the gym 6 days a week and just hit focus on one body part per day. So this is more of my traditional bro split. So day one, quads and calves. Day two, chest, which was yesterday. Day three, back, which is today. Day four, which is arms, that's tomorrow. Day five, hams and calves. And then day six will be shoulders and traps. And then take a day off and repeat it. And so I actually just got a question on my IG about, you're natural, why do you like a bro split and only train one time a week and don't have more frequency? This split works really well for me. You know, I've made gains for many, many years training like this. And so, and I also do the multiple body parts, hitting body parts multiple times a week. But I kind of always gravitate back to the bro split. And so I think switching up and going between the two is really beneficial, keeps my body guessing. Like my chest today is freaking wrecked. I don't get that type of soreness, which isn't necessarily an indication of growth or anything, but I don't get that type of soreness when I'm training multiple times a week chest because I do less volume. So I like to mix it up. I think there's definitely benefits for hypertrophy by mixing it up. So that's what we're gonna do. So today we're gonna do a bunch of different exercises, probably two pull down motions, maybe three rowing motions. I've been sticking away from deads probably the last 6 or 8 weeks because I was having a little bit of a back issue. Actually, the last time I was in this gym, I couldn't even stand up. A little dry needling straightened me out almost like instantly. And so I've been back to doing heavy rows and squats and stuff like that, but just haven't put deadlifts back in. So I've been making what I feel like are good gains right now, not deadlifting, even though I'd love to do it. Just a little hesitant to put those back in. So we're gonna crush a bunch of different exercises here. Right, Cuck?
Yeah,
that's what we have to do, man.
He will be my special friend who I'll be bringing along. So we'll probably do some different styles, different range of motions. As you can see, we train different. We all have different range of motions, and I think you'll see that with Carl and I. So let's get it. You can get in there, Cuck, if you want. I gotta loosen up the shoulders a little bit. Oh, chesticles. Oh. So I usually warm up the rotators a little bit, do a little rolling on this pipe. I wonder if they could hear that.
I'm
This is like the best lat pull down machine ever created. This
flex. I don't see anybody buying the air fresheners. Well, only them, the people don't get excited to tell me that they have one.
Oh, yeah. So. Flex Fitness, that was out of the blue. Flex Fitness lat pull down started with 120, stack goes to like 285. As you can see, with a lot of the stuff I do with back, I train 20 reps. I mean, I don't know why necessarily, it's just kind of the way I've developed through the years, but I've continually tried to go up in weight, and I'll still do a heavy weight at the 20 rep range. We'll probably work up to the stack and for probably 20, and then maybe throw some more weight on. But right now we're just getting warmed up, so I'll do 20 reps with 120, 20 reps with 180, 20 reps with 240, 20 reps with the stack. In theory, this is what I'm planning on doing. I don't know if I'll do it, but right now that's what I'm thinking. And then probably do a set or two with some extra weight on it. So on this, I try to definitely keep my chest up. I rock back a little bit, but I try not to get too crazy with it. Maybe when I go in really heavy, but I really just focus on driving back with the elbows, chest up, which is a little hard today because my chest is sore. Let's go. I'm doing this to warm up my hips. When I do it, I never bring my feet in this close because it takes the pressure off. So it's always step and then step to shoulder width, step to shoulder width. Keeps constant tension on the hips, kind of relieves some pressure and loosens up the lower back so that your glutes are firing and you're bracing your core more. It seemed to help my warm up. Smells delicious. All right, third set, we're at 240 now. Going for 20 again. Years are right down. Right, Cuck? You used to write it down.
Yeah. Back to check, back.
That's right. What he said. Flex, wide, pull down. 20, 20, 20. I'm going to put it down in my book because that means I have to do it now. Because I don't want to rewrite it. 20 with a stack. I need headphones. This music's just not going to work. Light. That's the Tiger Fitness funnel right there. Supporting our retailers. Tiger Fitness funnel. Showing a little love. Lemon drop, baby. Cuck, what are you going, what weight are you going for? Stackage?
Yeah, the whole stack.
All right. So as you saw in that last set, which was a stack, was just starting to get heavy. I was rocking a little bit, but still trying to keep my chest up and my elbows back. So even though I do initiate a little bit with a little bit of an arch, I still try to drive the elbows back, keep the chest up, and really feel it in my back. Again, this is one of those things, and it might not look like I'm straightening my arms, but I really am for me. They really don't go much straighter than that. So again, it comes down to your body mechanics, where you feel it, where your mind-muscle connection is. Carl, can you hold this thing down? Like over here? Can you hold it down? Like, wah. Wah. Ooh. 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 Let's go. Come on. All right, 5 sets of 20, working up to a plate on top of the stack. I'm warm now, so what are we doing?
Hammer? Hammer row.
Hammer row, some type of hammer row. So we're doing a hammer row next. I always like to mix things up. This is a Cuck style, so Cuck's doing, he's not putting his on the seat. He's standing, he's doing an overhand. I'm gonna see, usually I go by feel. So it depends on how I'm feeling on that day, whether I like the grip more neutral or the overhand grip. And then, so the way he's pulling it, I bet you he's feeling that real nice, like up in his trap area, you know what I'm saying? So I'll get in there and see how it's feeling today and decide. It's kind of like a game time decision. Listen to my body, you know, kind of feel the weight moving, see where I like it the best, and then I'll make a decision on how I'm gonna train it.
That's important.
Oh, I like
when
it.
I'm pulling it back.
But it's kind of like.
I feel it back to here.
Yeah.
Yeah. I'm still feeling it there.
Please touch me. Make sure I'm doing it right. Touch me. There you go. Yeah. Oh, I like that. A little more gentle. Yep. Oh, two hands. That's right. Oh, that's better. Right like that. All right. The moaning's a little much. So the thing with this one, I like to really get a full extension, really feel my lats like spreading as I go down. So this is one of those things you can load up 6 plates on here and rep it out, but I found through the years going a little bit lighter, getting just a full extension, better squeeze, I feel this one better. Two. The other thing I found is you can see Cuck's doing Versa grips. I love Versa grips for like deadlifts and shrugs, but I found when I train back, even on pull downs, I'm going heavy. I find when I use Versa grips, I don't feel it as much in my lats or in my back. I don't know why. I don't know if it's pulling something weird on my arm, but I actually have really liked to, unless I'm going super heavy and my wrist strength is giving out, or my forearm strength is giving out, I really try to go without VersaGrips. Overhand grip, it's a little harder because it's more of a tendency to slide out. So we'll see how this goes as I go heavier, but I really feel like it helps my back and my mind-muscle connection when I'm not using VersaGrips. Let's go. I can see on this one, I will probably need Versas after saying that. Just the overhand, your grip kind of goes, but we'll see. Let's go three, Cuck. You got three? Going 2.25. I never like to get an urgent message from Jeremy Hall in the middle of my workout. What's up? Yeah, GNC just sent us a letter saying they want to send back or destroy a whole pallet of America Energy Apple because it doesn't have expiration date. Even though the expiration dates are on the cans and the cases, so I don't know.
Ooh, get it.
Ooh. The overhand grip is definitely harder.
Yeah.
And it is a challenge, so my forearm is giving out a little bit because I've been having some wrist issues.
It takes a little bit of your biceps out of it, you know? Gives me a fighting chance.
Let's see, he gets 15. I think he'll get one more than whatever I tell him, so I got 12. Come on. Yep. Come on. How many? 13.
11 and an ugly one.
Yeah, I got 15. See, if I would have told him 15, he would have got like 15. This is definitely an interesting grip alteration. I'm open to trying new things. That's why it's always fun to train with somebody. So I still think I probably prefer the grip down like this, but I'm already 3 sets deep, so I'm gonna finish. It's definitely easier with your hands like this. Let's go. Light, light, light. Come on.
Go.
Bah. 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 Definitely hitting Mike in my pants. This is usually bad mojo, like the little one inside the big one, but I'm gonna live on the edge today. Hammer row. I'm gonna put cuck grip. Cuck grip. No seat. No seat. And then we did 15. I only put what's on one side. What do we start with? One plate?
One plate.
45. And then we did 90 on each side. Then we did 135. Then we did 180 on each side. That's how I write it down. That's the secret right there. I don't know if I'm feeling the outer row, bro.
No?
Nah.
It's definitely because I feel it in my bottom.
For me, it's definitely harder.
Oh, totally harder. Yeah.
I'm gonna see how I feel. I might do a drop on this. You ready? Might do a drop.
When I do it though, I'm focused on pulling this way and not this way, which is kind of like what you're used to doing. You doing that?
Yeah.
So I'm pulling back.
Can you get me pull it down to probably three plates?
Yeah.
On each side.
Oh shit! Logic kicking in.
Here we go. Let's get a couple here. Light.
Get it. Get it.
Yep, yep. After doing the pull downs, we did five sets, that low hammer row with a drop at the end. Now he's gonna do what we call cuck deads, which are almost kind of like a partial dead. I'm doing more straight pen lay rows from the floor. Try to be real explosive, a little bit of back motion in there, but try not to do too much. When I go heavy, I will a little bit, but probably work up to three plates or so. Here's your cuck deads. He doesn't like to touch the bottom, so. So on these, I'll just keep going up, probably by 25 pounds on the side from here on out, trying to still get 10 reps. I really don't do anything much less than 10 reps, and I don't really do much over 10 reps on this because it's, as you can hear me breathing, this is like a full body exercise. These things are like, they're like a deadlift from your waist up, even though you do feel it in your glutes as well. But try to be real explosive off the bottom, no matter how heavy or light the weight is. Let's go. talk us through it. Walk it like a talk. No, okay, sorry. Chill, chill, chill. All right, three plates, pen lay. I try to keep my back as flat to the ground as possible, but you know, you can see a little leg motion in there, but I try to pull as explosively as I can. Really emphasis on explosive on the positive part here. My nose is running too. So all those boogers in these frames, that's free. That's free. All right, here we go. Say that pen lay rows, beep, they take it out of you. They're like just as hard as deadlifts, maybe even harder in some regards. Five sets of pull downs, five sets of hammer row, five sets of pen lay. I did five sets of 10. Actually, last set was 11. My back is really tight right now, my lower back. Actually, my glute a little bit. I got a little loose on the form on the end of that, but it felt really good. I'm getting my strength back up on that. And now we're gonna hit another row. This isn't a carrying row. I'm probably gonna go with like a neutral grip on this. Wow. Again, 20 reps, working up in weight. Probably next set will be stacked. We're probably gonna have to add some weight on here. On this, I'm still focusing on pulling elbows back. Let's go. Has done it again. How many sets and reps for each exercise do you do? We're training back right now. This is our fourth exercise. We've done five sets on the first three exercises, probably four sets on this. Shit, I'm not even recording. How do you like that? All right, how many sets and reps for each exercise? This is back workout. This is exercise number four. First three exercises, five sets, then four sets on this fourth exercise, three to four sets on the last exercise, maybe 20, 25 work sets on a normal day.
Yeah, bro.
All right, how many sets and reps for each exercise?
Third set, plate in the stack. I'm not sure why I even have the verses on. I'm not using them.
Yeah.
Hey, don't try to sound like a cop workout.
Fucking disgrace. Came over here.
Hey. Your cab workout. So if you buy my workout, I'll throw in the cop. Wait. Two easy steps. I'll throw in the cholesterol.
Well, I don't do much cardio, so it's all in the training. Let's go. Look at that cuck face.
Let me do 20. I do 10.
Ooh. And you can't see out of one eye. Here we go. Last set. Yep. Come on. Chop. All right, that's four exercises. A lot of volume, including all that reps, heavy weight. So we'll probably do one to two more exercises here. Probably because everyone else is done training. Probably only one. They've been done for like 45 minutes. Cuck and I have been here crushing it. The two old guys. So we're gonna do cuck pull downs next. You've probably seen me do these in some videos, but we have the cuck himself to show you cuck pull downs. Great stretch at the end of your workout. Let's go. All right. Just crushing some questions in between sets. Last set. These are cuck pull downs. The key with these is the stretch. Oh, all the way to floor. You know what, Carl? I can't do them here. Maybe I can. Yeah. So the rope wasn't long enough, so I was hitting at the top, but as you can see, we switched to the rope so we can get a better stretch. The key here is the stretch at the top, drive with the elbows. I just really like being able to sit on the floor. I don't feel so restricted. And I feel like I can keep the form tighter. So you drive your elbows back down towards your lats. Now you can't go that heavy because it's only really his body weight holding him down. If he can put his foot up, he can hold himself down better. But you know, he's just got 165 where he could probably do closer to the stack if he was sitting. Let's go. said, I don't usually use grips on pull downs, but this, the forearm and the grip definitely go because this is an awkward rope. So I feel it so much better using. All right, that's a wrap. Three sets here, one drop set. My back and biceps were pretty pumped, and I'm having trouble. If you saw in that last set, I can't even like pull down to my chest. So that's a wrap. We've been here probably an hour and a half. Got a good 25 sets in. Good workout. That's a typical back workout, probably around that much volume. Maybe if we have a little extra time, we'll squeeze in maybe one more exercise like pullovers, something like that. But that's a wrap. Pause for the screenshot.